The Troy War is one of the events in human history which has had a great impact on world culture from ancient times to the present day. Although many works have been written that reflect the events and happenings related to it, many question these events. Did these events really happen, or are they the fruit of human fantasy? And what reinforces these doubts more is the fact that the exact place where these events are located is not known. Many archaeologists and historians accept as the location of the ancient city of Troy the ruins found on Hisarlik Hill, which is located in the west of today's Turkey. There are others who do not accept it, and there are others who think that the location of ancient Troy is somewhere else. Today, there are all possible means to prove or reject the various assumptions. For a detailed study, we will examine some elements which are fundamental and very important in the progress and continuity of events in ancient Troy. We must bear in mind that the War of Troy lasted about 10 years. We are facing a city with thousands of inhabitants that for 10 years is facing an enemy, which they have in front of the city gates. The inhabitants of this city need water, food, weapons, and wood to cook and warm up. In front of us is an enemy army made up of thousands of soldiers. These are also thousands of soldiers who, for 10 years in a row, need water, food, weapons, and wood for heating and cooking. This means that in the space where both sides were operating, some vital conditions had to be met, without which this event itself could not continue for so long. 10 years is a very long time. The first necessary condition is the presence of many water sources. You need a terrain with rivers and many water sources present in the city, as well as in the enemy's camp. Even the enemy army in its camp. It had to be near any river or different springs. And in fact, Homer in the Iliad mentions many rivers which flowed from the Ida mountain range and into the sea. Rhesus, Heptapyrus, Chersis, Rhodius, Granicus, and Aesepus, and the sacred river Scamander and Simois. And especially three are mentioned more: Scamander, Xanthus, and Simois. From the satellite images, it is clear that it is a very rich terrain with water reserves that are so necessary for the city, but also for the enemy army that wanted to conquer the city. In the second place, Troy had to be a big city and located in a terrain that gave the citizens the opportunity to be supplied with water, food, weapons, and wood. To be supplied, they had to be able to move without being noticed from the enemy. And in the event that they were spotted by the enemy, the terrain created an opportunity for them to hide and save themselves. But in order to move without being endangered by the enemy, they should be able to control the movements of the enemy army from the city. The terrain had to give them the opportunity to control the enemy's movements from afar. On the other hand, the enemy was stationed near the sea. This gave them the opportunity to be supplied with food from the sea. But if the weather did not allow them, then they launched attacks against other smaller cities, which they plundered. For example, Briseis, for whom Achilles was angry with Agamemnon, was kidnapped in one of the attacks on a city near Troy. This means that the region where the city of Troy was should have been a region with many other cities at distances not too far from each other. It was populated with different cities that were located close to each other. With these vital elements in mind for the progress of events, let's begin a flight over the area that is accepted as the location of ancient Troy. What appears at first is the smallness of the hill on which the city was located. It appears to be a small hill, surrounded by plains. Many researchers assume that the size of the city was larger than the area that includes the Hisarlik Hill. Even if this is true, the city lies in the plains, and this makes it easy to surround it by all sides. And a city surrounded from all sides has few opportunities to supply weapons and food. Because it can be assumed that water was provided from the many wells that were located in the city. From the pictures, it is clear that it is not an area rich in water sources. This means that water reserves were few for both the besiegers and the besieged. It is known from the many examples from history that many cities have not resisted the siege precisely because of the lack of water. Because without food you can resist for a month, without water you cannot resist for more than a week. If we accept that ancient Troy was located in today's Turkey, then Mount Ida is located about 40 kilometers from the city of Troy. On the other hand, Homer describes several cases where boys from Troy raised sheep and goats in the mountains of Ida. And 40 kilometers is a great distance to travel together with sheep and goats. How did they manage to move without falling in the eyes of the enemy when they passed between the fields? Didn't the food caravans that came from other cities near Troy stand out? They passed through the fields before they reached the city. It is clear from the satellite images that it was impossible not to be seen by the enemy. And without food and weapons, the city could not resist for 10 years. These are views from the satellite, and as it seems, even the satellite that moves at high speed needs time to travel the space from the city of Troy to Mount Ida. These distances are impossible to travel every day without falling into the eyes of the enemy. Is a long time. It is a very long time for a city that has the enemy in front of the city gates. The city had to rise to a suitable relief to be supplied with water, food, weapons, and wood for cooking and heating. From the views, the mountain that is accepted as the Mountain of Ida can be seen on the horizon. Let's start a flight over the city of Luzhë, which is located in the northwest of Albania. Satellite images clearly show the size of the city. The city stretches from the edge of the river to the top of the hill. The hill is very high, and from its height, during the day, the movements of the enemy who had set up camp on the seashores were observed. This gave the inhabitants the opportunity to move without being in danger from the enemy, to graze their cattle, to be supplied with water, food, wood, and weapons. The ranges are located very close to the city, and as it seems from all sides, it is surrounded by hills and mountains. The hills and mountains near the city are covered with dense forests, and the Trojans were easily supplied with wood. Caravans with water and food moved freely and supplied the city at any time. In such conditions, opportunities are created to resist an enemy located near the city for 10 years in a row. In addition to this, Loja also had wells for water inside the castle, as can be seen from the photos. From these images, it is clear that, in the difficult moments when the enemy was able to conquer the city, many Trojans had the opportunity to save even though the enemy was in their house. And this becomes clear precisely because of the favorable terrain. Anyone who sees these pictures understands that only such a terrain gives you the opportunity to leave in a hidden way from the enemy. It is enough to cross from the other side of Shelwani Mountain and you are saved. Passing through these mountains, you can reach Thrace, and they were allies of the Trojans, so it is enough to reach Thrace and they were saved from the enemy. And this is one reason why the attack was made from the sea and not from the land. In the first instance, the terrain was very difficult, and in the second instance, it was necessary to pass through areas that were allies of the Trojans. Passing through these valleys, you arrive in Thrace. In addition to this, there are many old cities in the vicinity of Loja, Shkodra, Velipoya, Kroya, and Duras. And we also have ruins of old cities located in the space from Shkodra in the north to Duras in the south. The name Velipoja itself seems to be an ancient city because Velipoja comes from Velipolis, i.e. the city of Veli. In Albanian, we use the suffix poja instead of pali. For example, the whole world calls Constantinople the city founded by Constantine, while in Albania we call it Constantinopoja. These facts clearly show that only Loja is the ancient city of Troy. Thank you for watching this video.